A Servo Sentry is a combat mechanoid that drops via grav impeller motors and provides a quill on kill themes with fire support. Though slow moving, they are able to reposition during battle, obeying defensive subroutines to guard their team's flanks or fighting rearguard actions while their comrades fall back. Hello there and welcome to this painting guide. In this video, I'll be taking you through how to paint your very own Servo Sentry that comes in the awesome new quill on kill team. So let's get started. Here's a list of all the paints we'll be using. With that said, these are just our suggestions, so feel free to change them up to fit your colour scheme. And here's also a list of all the additional equipment that we've used. Same again here, use whatever is comfortable for you. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, check out our Painting Essentials playlist for more info on how to paint. I've gone ahead and equipped my Servo Sentry with the Volley Gun, but there's loads of other alternatives to choose from, like the Flamer for example. But all the paint steps are pretty much the same, so it's no biggie if your model hasn't got the same weaponry as mine. Now, the two main colours on our Quillon Sentry Gun are black and silver, which means we have two great options for the undercoat, Chaos Black or Lead Belcher. I've gone with Lead Belcher just because I think there's a tiny bit more silver on the model than black, but obviously you can use whichever undercoat is right for you. Up next is Black Legion to fill in all the black areas. If you went for a black undercoat, just fill in all the silver areas here instead with Lead Belcher. I'll be taking this straight from the pot and applying it in a couple layers. You may find that just one layer works for you, or you may need more. Either way, the end result should look something like this. With the two main base colours down, now we can start picking out the more intricate details. So now I'm going to paint all the trim using Runelord Brass. I'm going to thin this down with a little water and apply it in two thin layers. Be as careful as you can not to get any of this onto the silver or the black, but obviously don't worry if you do. We can always go back and neaten up any mistakes that we make. When you're all done, we can move on. Next up, we'll just quickly base coat the skull in the centre of the sentry using Xandri Dust. Once again, I'll be applying this in two thin layers. With that finished, that concludes our final base coat. Now onto Agrax Earthshade for an all-over shade. Depending on how grimy you want your Servo Sentry to be, you may want to thin this down with some water or Lamia Medium first. I'm adding it straight from the pot, but you can thin it down first if you want to. Work this around the entire model and keep your eyes peeled for any pooling. Once you're done, leave it for about 30 minutes to dry before moving on. And with that shade dry, our Servo Sentry is actually looking really awesome. It's looking super defined now, and you could totally skip straight to painting the base for it to be battle ready. But there's a few simple extra steps that you can do first if you have the time, so stick around if you're interested. The first extra step we're going to do to our Servo Sentry is paint the red lenses. Now there's quite a few ways to tackle lenses like this, and I'll be going for a simple contrast paint approach. So I'll start with a couple thin layers of Corax White. But if you want to paint your lenses in the more traditional and detailed way, Adam has actually done a video teaching you all about it, so go check it out. Anyway, back to the contrast method. Once the Corax White is dry, I'll be adding Blood Angels Red all over each lens. Feel free to switch this out of a brighter or darker red, or even a different colour entirely. Any contrast paint will work for this, so it's completely up to you what you go with. And boom, it's that simple. Some really neat lenses done super quickly. Now I'm going to move on to adding some quick highlights, but remember you can skip straight to basing if highlighting isn't for you. First up, I'll be using Dawnstone to highlight all the black. Whether you dry brush this on, edge highlight, or even use a mixture of both methods is completely up to you. Either way, adding some highlights here will really take the black details up a notch. After that, I'll use Stormhost Silver to highlight all the metals. Same again here, apply this in whichever method takes your fancy.
I really enjoyed painting this model and I'm super excited now to crack on with the rest of my Quill on Kill team. Hopefully you found this video useful too, and remember, if you're looking for more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can check out some of the other videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel. Alternatively, you can head to our Warhammer store where our amazing staff are always happy to help. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Bye bye!